Hello, I'm Reza Aslan. Welcome to the latest installment of Aslan Media's Book Salon. Today we have a wonderful conversation planned with you. I'm here with Rabbi Mark Schneier and Imam Shamzi Ali, who are the authors of a brand new book that they co-wrote together, The Sons of Abraham, a candid conversation about the issues that divide and unite Jews and Muslims. For those of you unfamiliar with our authors, of course, Rabbi Schneier is the founder and president of the Foundation for Ethnic Understanding. He's also the founding rabbi of the Hampton Synagogue in West Hampton Beach, New York. Imam Ali is the spiritual leader of the Jamaica Muslim Center, that's New York's largest Islamic center, and he also serves on the board of the Tannenbaum Center, which is a board that I serve on as well. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on Aslan Media.
Thank you, Aslan, for having us.
You know, this is a remarkable book, and I'm curious, what kind of relationship did the two of you have before this book that then sort of spurred the co-writing of this text?
Well, you know, Aslan, as you know that as an immigrant Muslim who came to this country, I was born in Indonesia. Later on went to Pakistan to study Islam and then to Saudi Arabia as well. I had a certain mindset about the Jewish people in the past, and that is something that I acknowledge very honestly to everyone, that we used to have that very, very bad image about the Jewish people, particularly when it comes to the issue of chosenness, where many Muslims think that the conspiracy theory that Muslims have, and I call this poison in the mind of many Muslims these days, basically is emanated from the concept of chosenness. And so when I came to this country, I was kind of suspicious about particularly the Jewish people. Because in my mind, Jewish people control the United States of America. So when I came to this country, I said, can I practice my religion and I'm going to interact with Jewish people? That September 11 happened. I never met any Jew prior to that. When that happens, I was entrusted to represent the Muslim community into many, many occasions, including meeting President Bush, representing the Muslim at the Yankee Stadium, Pray for America, and many others. But I still had a very bad perception of the Jewish community until 2005, when Pope John died. I was invited by CBS television to an interview about Pope John's interfaith outreach to the non-Christians. And I was representing the Muslim community, and thereby represented the Jewish community. So we met, basically, and literally, like I said, barely we looked at each other. Almost we didn't look at each other. We shook hands, but we didn't look at each other, because I had some sort of suspicion, and I don't know why Rabbi didn't want to see my face at that time. But luckily, several months later, we met, and that meeting was the beginning of the journey. And our connection, our relations right now is not only as a friend. We are here to fight for each other.
Rabbi Schneier, I've heard this story, and I'm sure you've heard this story, many times from many different people. Muslim immigrants who come to this country who have been given this kind of stereotype about Jews from growing up in majority Muslim countries coming to the United States, this sense of how the Jews are controlling this country, all of that stuff. You must have heard this so many times. What do you do when you're confronted with this kind of image from your Muslim friends?
I recall participating in July 2008 in Madrid, Spain. It was the first interreligious interfaith conference that was convened by King Abdullah of Saudi Arabia. And it was convened in cooperation with the World Muslim League. There was a panel at the conference. Dr. Al-Turki, who's the Secretary General of the Muslim World League, myself and a few other faith communities were representing our respective peoples on the panel. And Dr. Turki begins the conference and that particular discussion by stating that as Muslims, we can dialogue with every major faith community in this room, but the Jewish people. So I was expecting, of course, it was going to be a result of the Israeli-Palestinian ongoing conflict? He said, no, absolutely not. How can we dialogue with the people that believe they are the chosen people, that Jews are the elite, that Jews are superior, that Jews feel that they're above everyone else? And that's one of the sensitive topics that we address in this book.
Mm-hmm.
And I learned from the imam, just as we have the concept of chosenness, which does not mean better, does not mean superior.
It does not mean what many people think it means. That's right.
Right. If anything, you know, that we were given a mandate by God to bring an ethical, monotheistic value system to the world, which is a manifestation of Christianity and Islam, Judaism being the mother religion today.
And not an enviable job either, I have to say.
No, I mean, we paid our dues for 2,000 years, no question. Particularly when it's come to the Christian world, we paid for that. But coming back to our discussion, so the imam taught me how in the Quran, that Muslims have a concept known as Khair Ummah, which is translated as the best nation. So my friend Imam Shamsi always says, let the best nation meet the chosen people, and then we'll say, exactly what we're talking about here.
You know, what's wonderful about this book, of course, is that so much of it reminds us of something that both communities should know, which is the shared experience that Jews and Muslims have had, particularly in the United States. I mean, the numbers of Jews and Muslims in America are, fairly equivalent, maybe about 6 million Jews, maybe about 4 million Muslims. The immigration patterns have had a lot of striking similarities. The xenophobia that both communities have experienced. There's so much, it seems, that Jews and Muslims have in common with each other. And yet, rather than sometimes that shared experience driving the two communities closer, it seems to drive them apart. Why do you think that is, besides just the sort of general sort of misunderstanding of each other that we've talked about already? Imam Ali, what do you think the situation is?
Yes, I think, in terms of religions, these are the most identical two religions in the world. From theological perspective down to social issues that we have, my friend Rabbi Machnai used to say, we don't only share common faith, but also common fate, destiny. Mm-hmm. So we both have the same path. And I think the most important issue why these two communities are becoming divided is that we don't want to challenge our pre-existing conception about others. You know, we have something in the back of our head that we don't want to challenge. You know, we have been hijacked by our own ignorance. And I'm talking about myself. You know, we came from a majority Muslim nation, Indonesia, went to Pakistan during the Soviet Union invasion to Afghanistan, then lived in Saudi Arabia for 3 years. During those years, we have been, bombarded by information about Jewish being bad peoples, and they wanted to rule the world. You know, these kind of things basically, influenced our mindsets about the Jewish people. And so I think the challenge is how to fight against the perception, the ignorance. Secondly, some Muslims tend to use Middle East conflict as justification to hate Jews. But in fact, it is not. At the end of the time, at the day when we argue with any Muslim, they will say it is because of Israel and Palestine. But in fact, it is not. It is because of the ignorant understanding of our holy text, of our holy books, the passages that we have in our holy books. The Quran talk about, Jews, that Jews and Christians will never be pleased with you until you follow their religion. So always there is a suspicion that these people wanted to force us to become Jews or Christians. And so the misconception is very, very huge. The mistrust is very deep. But I think the biggest one is because of that ignorance that we have about each other.
We'll be right back with the second part of our conversation with Rabbi Schneier and Imam Ali, the co-authors of Sons of Abraham, the candid conversation about the issues that divide and unite Muslims and Jews.